One, two, three, five. Well, she was just 17. Did you know what I mean? And the way she looked was way beyond.
Hi, I'm Sven Rygrock, and I play the role of this boy.
Where's my fucking lighter?
You what?
The Dunhill, it was there by the Cartier. Where the fuck is it?
I haven't touched any lighter.
Just give it back now.
You're accusing me.
It's worth more than you'll ever make. Where else would it be?
I don't know, do I? And besides, if I was going to nick your lighter, I would have had that watch, your wallet, and anything else I could lay my hands on.
Just give it back now and we will say no more.
I said I haven't got it, have I? I'd say you could search me, but they're your clothes, aren't they, you softgets?
Don't you dare speak to me like that.
Sure, I started off with the Spud films. So doing Spud 1, 2 and 3, which was a great journey for me. A lot of film and television. I got to work with some really cool people and international people. And I've done some theatre like Maynardville. Did Shakespeare's Midsummer's Dream. Yeah. Yes. I think any accent is a challenge because it's one more thing that you have to focus on. It was a bit of a challenge. Because partly, yeah, the great thing about this boy is that he's almost anonymous. He could be anyone or anything. And so it's pretty much up to the audience to find out for themselves what does he mean and who is he to them. Yeah, films definitely. Films like This Is England, it's probably a great film for myself in terms of reference, in terms of the roughness of this character and the kind of lifestyle that they lived. Music, I suppose, yeah, when you do your own little research, the Beatles, yeah, it's there, it comes up, and it kind of gives one the sense of the energy of the time, that anything was possible. Probably Twist and Shout. No, it's great, it's different. I think the fear for all actors is that you can't hide anywhere. Like with screen and stuff, you don't have a big cast, you don't have elaborate costumes, so it's about being authentic and real and trying to produce that all the time. So it's nerve-wracking, it's a place of immense unknown and danger, but it's a thrill. He's great. He's a great director. He's somebody who you can, somebody who you can trust. He makes it very easy to work with. He's not forceful of his agenda and he's inclusive. So he allows your freedom and your creativity to come to the plate and then he's able to push it much higher than you ever thought possible. Because I think our generation, I'm talking about our generation and younger, we are lonely. We have instant communication, we can communicate across multiple platforms and all over the world, but in terms of what's happening right now in our own lives, I think our own fears, our own emotions, our own everything, we are neglecting. We put up our best selves and our best versions of Facebook and on Instagram, but the truth of who we are, we bury. And this play kind of unravels that.
One, two, three, five!